hello, my subscribers. So as you can tell, I just decided to show a few tapes of mine. There are some that are not going to be shown on camera for reasons, but I'm just going to leave it at that. Anyway, without further ado, this is going to be my discussion slash my memories with VHS, since it's primarily becoming a thing of the past now, and it's not really a technology that's making a comeback like vinyls is right now, so yeah. So let's, without further ado, get on into it. So, yeah, without further ado, this is definitely a form of technology got a lot of nostalgia for, and definitely many great memories, and there's still some that I'm rediscovering, and some that I'm looking at over again that might convert digitally, so I have this version of them. So yeah, I guess I'll just discuss my history, and just some really great things I've noticed about this form of media, and I guess some other stuff that I don't miss, but yeah. And just discuss the various different uses for it, even though one of them I never really used it for it, that being TV. Never had a TV series on VHS, it was always just movies and whatnot. So, guess I'll go ahead and give a brief overview, since I have a little bit of knowledge on the history of the platform. So, from what I heard, or not heard, but from what I've researched, VHS was the competitor to Sony's Betamax, that had like a smaller version of the VHS tape, the VHS tape being the rectangle, but it lost out in the format war. So anyway, that caught on in the 1970s, and it was initially a very hesitant, studios were initially very hesitant of it up until there was this one Supreme Court case where I think Disney and Universal sued either Toshiba or Panasonic, one of those two companies, I'm not exactly sure. It might have been RCA also, because they were big VHS tapes for a while. But, really enjoyed that. That was a nice little fun bit of history there. And, quite frankly, from what I've seen, Betamax wasn't really that much better, so I'm glad VHS ended up winning. But also I know it was used to record TV shows. Oh, I actually do have some experience with TV now that I think about it. My grandma did record some episodes of many Cartoon Network shows that I watched, so I do have some experience. I just never sat down and watched like a whole box set of one particular show, at least those that were on it. Obviously now it's all streaming, so yeah. But anyway, I guess, like most people, I started off VHS-wise with many classic Disney movies, and these being from the era that would soon begin to be known as the Disney Renaissance. But yeah, these were movies like Little Mermaid, Beauty and the Beast, Aladdin, Lion King, Pocahontas, Hunchback of Notre Dame, and Hercules. I didn't actually ever get the last two on VHS, so I primarily just watched them on Disney Plus or wherever. But those being Mulan and Tarzan. So gosh, I also remember too, my grandma used to have a really good backlog of many movies, and recently I wanted to get Spider-Man, the Tobey Maguire movie, because apparently I wore out my DVD of it, because it will just simply not play. I must have watched it a lot. Neither disc works. So I was hoping to have that VHS so I could continue to watch it until it eventually degraded, maybe converted it digitally, but now I guess I'll be streaming it until I can find another copy, VHS or DVD or otherwise, so yeah. And with Sony and the way they handle their streaming services, I might need a physical copy, because who knows where that's going to go. And apparently Judy, I'm going to make a cameo, he has been sitting on my lap while I've been watching some VHS tapes, haven't you, Juju Bean? Say hi, everyone, Juju Bean. Say hi. Saying hi. Juju Bean. Anyway, yeah. Really gotta say, those Disney movies were pretty dang awesome to watch, all of them, and it was so nice to get the tapes rewound, and usually you'd be in for a pretty dang awesome movie if you threw one of those in. Only downside is when you had to rewind the tapes. There's one big negative right there, is rewinding it. And if you don't have a tape rewinder, rewinding it in your actual set is gonna damage your VCR set, along with the VHS itself. So always nice to have a rewinder, but those are few and far between now. Thankfully, I tend to have access to one, so I don't have to have that happen to them. But even non-Disney movies, pretty dang awesome. You watch a Paramount movie and you hear the classic Paramount theme, like when I watch my VHS copy of Forrest Gump. Oh, along with the Warner Brothers classic little theme that we play, especially when I watch it like that at the animated series VHS tapes rented out from Blockbuster. So I still remember going to Blockbuster a lot to rent VHS tapes. Even though near the end of Blockbuster and Hollywood Video's run, they did eventually stop giving VHS tapes as an option to rent and then just being DVDs and video games. But nonetheless, quite some good times too. And I remember the way I used to have stuff in my basement where I'd watch all the movies and TV shows and play all my video games, so those were really nice. But it's also nice too to capture the some of the past. One thing I've noticed is when I rewatched the old tape recording of the classic Justice League cartoon, Rest in Power, Kevin Conroy, the voice of Batman, and gosh dang, seeing all the old advertisements for, like, gosh, all the food companies, video games, and toys, oh boy. Nice little time capsule for that, that's for sure. And also I noticed on some VHS tapes, if you, like, stayed to the end credits, it'd give some kind of a bonus. I was just watching the wedding singer one, and it was like a karaoke version at the end. And the Spider-Man one, I remember, had, like, a music video, I think. Oh, and it also had a really nice intro by Stan Lee. Another reason why I'm disappointed I couldn't do that. But, it is what it is. Who knows? Maybe I can find one going to an antique shop or something like that. But, It's also why I'm glad for my birthday or Christmas or something a while ago, I got a VHS DVD hybrid player, so there is still a VCR that I can use here, but it's not pointless when I got DVD player, or the hybrid player, but nonetheless, all pretty dang solid. And upon rewatching some tapes, the movie's just so good, and I don't know, I guess I kind of like watching the ads that I play for them too, as it's a nice little time capsule from the 90s, the decade where a lot of the tapes I own were from, with the exception of some classic John Hughes tapes I got, like Breakfast Club and Ferris Bueller's Day Off, and also Top Gun. But and there are definitely some VHS tapes that I don't care if I were to sell them, and someone would offer me $1 million and lunch with the cast and crew of the movie you made of, like, Top Gun or Toy Story. I don't think I could ever sell them. Like, it's too special. I can't do it. Even my Batman the Animated Series tapes. I mean, I know I got the Blu-ray collector set, but I still gotta hold on to, like, the tapes. The one with Batman focusing on him, and the other one focusing on him. So, just can't do it. But also, too, the other nice thing was the clamshell case VHS tapes. Boy, these were awesome form of packaging, especially when you open it and make a little pop sound anytime you open the clamshell case. I know that the Disney ones have that, especially the classics and the masterpiece collection, so close the nice. And, even some non-Disney movies also have a new, like, copy of Pokemon's first movie, and Grinch, and Willy Wonka and Chocolate Factory, and also the re-release of E.T. But, yeah, gosh, that was so freaking awesome. I think a few times I also rented a copy of Batman Master of Phantasm. Gosh, I wish I would have got that one. That would have been a real nice VHS to have, because not only is it an awesome movie, but it's nice to see the little ads from that era of Batman. That'd be nice. Might have to look at that around in some antique shops here, but I don't know if we'll have it. We'll see. Along with Space Jam, that'd be another nice one too. But thanks to HBO Max and also my Blu-ray collector set, watching whatever the hell I want, so it's not that big of a deal. It's more of a nostalgic thing. But, yeah. But yeah, I guess those were. And besides all the warm feelings and all that too, I guess, the other nice thing too. Oh shoot, I just thought about another negative that I found out. It may not be applicable to all VHS players, VCRs, but I noticed that sometimes when I pause a tape, like, it only stayed paused for a limited amount of time, and then it would continue after a while. So that was one thing to look out for. Go to the bathroom or go get food. You gotta check up on that thing and remember where you left off at, so make sure you're doing that. And, also, besides the rewinding, that definitely, that was the one thing that, boy, that could definitely suck, but, yeah. And, I guess that's really about it on the downside, so, no, that's really about it. And, I guess storage-wise, depending on what type of case you have, if you have the clamshells, those can take up a lot of space, because they're pretty big, so. You have a lot of clamshell plates in some cases. You better make sure you have a rack or an entertainment center that can hold them all. So make sure you do that. I guess another positive too is you can actually convert these visually from the VHS, so it'll still be the same footage. Because one thing I've been discussing is like keeping a film's original vision or what the director wanted and all that stuff. And some streaming services have been doing edits. Like I noticed some in The Lion King and a few Warner Brothers movies, so it's kind of nice to have the raw, original, unedited version. So there's another plus, especially with The Lion King. There were some edits that really annoyed me that they did. But that's also really nice too, and I believe if you get converted digitally, there's a machine that you can buy and it'll do it for you, or you can pay someone to do it, so. Probably going to be getting on that here soon, but yeah. Because the other thing too is another downside I just remembered is VHS tapes can deteriorate in time, and there'll be signs like the screen flickering or it's skipping over stuff or the tape just stopping at a certain point, so you gotta watch out for that. There's very few places they'll repair it now, so kind of SOL if that happens. But yeah. Anyway, I guess that's the few other things that I just noticed. But yeah, watching the original film unedited is nice. Also, convert it over to digital if you don't feel like watching the edited version on the streaming. So that's also another nice thing too. And I guess you just gotta make sure you have enough storage space on your if you have a hard drive or your computer. My computer has had some moments where it's been almost shot with storage, so I've had to use the hard drive. So that's one thing I gotta look out for. So anyway, yeah, I guess that's my experience with my memories of watching VHS tapes from various different studios. I guess now I'll touch on a little bit of watching old family videos, and then after that I think I'm just going to wrap it up as well and done. So yeah, on that note, it sure is nice to go back and see those old videos. Boy, the way I sounded when I watched some of these tapes then compared to now, it's like a night and day difference. Gosh dang, I had really a freaking low-pitched voice, definitely not where it is now. Also, I can see what I loved wearing. It hasn't changed much. I'm always wearing like a Spider-Man mold or Pokemon shirt. Besides not wearing Pokemon shirts like I used to, I still wear geek shirts, like Marvel, Star Wars, Stranger Things, stuff like that. That hasn't changed. I also saw on another tape I was wearing a Spider-Man costume for Tobey Maguire almost about 20 years ago, so I guess it was fate that 20 years later I'd wear Spider-Man again on Halloween. And I'm going to be keeping that costume around for a while, probably wearing it every Halloween and probably any Comic-Con. So, yeah. Definitely, really fun memories there, and definitely really enjoyed that. So, anyway, hope you enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoyed hearing me talk about my experiences with VHS. And who knows, maybe it might make you want to go back and find some of yours if you have them. Or maybe if you're on the younger generations, you might want to go seek out and see what those things are. As you saw in the intro. Anyway, I guess go ahead and like, comment, subscribe, and peace.